I was afraid to speak while I was just a lad. Me father gave me nails a tweak and told me I was bad.
To create a new Disney World of entertainment. That garage was a long way from today's Walt Disney Productions in Burbank, California. Now, after 50 happy years of producing some of the most heartwarming and enjoyable entertainment, we'd like you to join us as we relive some of the highlights of those years. Five fabulous decades of entertainment that has reached out and touched people everywhere around the world.
Stumped one day when a little boy asked, "Do you draw Mickey Mouse?" And I had to admit I do not draw anymore. "Well, then you think up all the jokes and ideas." "No," I said, "I don't do that." Finally, he looked at me and said, "Mr. Disney, just what do you do?" "Well," I said, "sometimes I think of myself as a little bee. I go from one area of the studio to another and gather pollen and sort of stimulate everybody. I guess that's the job I do."
When Walt Disney arrived in California in 1923, they established the first animated cartoon studio in Hollywood with $500, which they borrowed from an uncle.
"So I was thinking if I had something with a novel twist, I might crack the market. I said, well, maybe I'll pull a reversal on that. I'll put the humans in with the cartoon."
It wasn't until 1928 that Walt enjoyed his initial major success with the first sound cartoon, Steamboat Willie, introducing a character called Mickey Mouse, the first cartoon character to stress personality, a touching and comic figure, satirizing society and contemporary events.
"Now, by nature, I'm an experimenter, so with the success of Mickey, I was determined to diversify. Sometime in early 33, and we got a very warm reception from the audience. All the little pigs seemed to register with them. And it was the thing we'd been working for a long time. Personality out of the character. Individual personality.
You'll be sorry when the wolf comes to your door."
By using well-known stories as a setting for his cartoon characters, Walt felt that he could give their personalities greater warmth, such as the bravery of Little Hiawatha. The sensitivity of the ugly duckling.
Somebody?
Yeah, two big monsters with big green eyes. Why, I...
Monsters? Weren't you afraid?
No, ma'am, but they tied me in a big sack.
You don't say. And where was Sir Jiminy?
Oh, Jiminy?
Leave me out of this.
They put him in a little sack.
No.
Yes.
How did you escape?
I didn't. They chopped me into firewood. Oh, look! My nose! What's happened?
Perhaps you haven't been telling the truth, Pinocchio.
Perhaps.
Oh, but I have. Every single word. Oh, please help me. I'm awful sorry.
You see, Pinocchio, a lie keeps growing and growing until it's as plain as the nose on your face.
She's right, Pinocchio. You better come clean.
I'll never lie again. Honest, I won't.
Please, Your Honor. Miss Fairy, give him another chance. For my sake, will you?
Well, I'll forgive you this once. But remember, a boy who won't be good might just as well be made of wood.
We'll be good, won't we?
Very well. But this is the last time I can help you.
Gee, look, Jiminy! My nose!
Almost from the beginning, Walt sensed the need to develop the fine art of animation. Here, in the old mill, artwork backgrounds became more believable, providing dramatic moods for the story. And for the first time, cartoons took on a three-dimensional effect. Start work on the first feature-length cartoon, Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs.
I actually started to plan the picture about 1935, and I fooled around with it, trying to get a hold of a story and things for a couple of years, and finally it began to gel. Then I went to work on it, and I finished it the fall of 1938. I didn't know what I had or what would happen or anything. We had the family fortune, we had everything wrapped up in Snow White.
Magic mirror on the wall, who is the fairest one of all?
Lips red as the rose, hair black as ebony, skin white as snow,
Snow White.
Now, don't forget, my dear, the old queen's a sly one, full of witchcraft. So beware the strangers.
Don't worry. I'll be all right. See you tonight.
Yes.
Well, come on, man.
Be awful careful. Because if anything had happened to you, I...
Goodbye.
Oh, God. Disgusting.
And be sure to watch out. Watch out. Thanks.
To find wider horizons of entertainment, Walt worked from classical music selections conducted by Leopold Stokowski to develop a new art form, way ahead of its time, called fantasia. Another dimension of Disney films was Walt's fondness for using music and songs to help tell his stories. Remember these?
Zippity-doo-da, zippity-ay. My, oh my, what a wonderful day. Plenty of sunshine heading my way. Zippity-doo-da, zippity-ay. Mr. Bluebird's on my shoulder.
It's the truth. It's actual.
Everything is satisfactual. Zippity-doo-dah, zippity-ay. Wonderful feeling, wonderful day.
It's supercalifragilisticexpialidocious. Even though the sound of it is something quite atrocious, if you say it loud enough, you'll always sound precocious. Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
Because I was afraid to speak when I was just a lad. My father gave me nails a tweak and told me I was bad. But then one day I learned a word to save me aching nose.
The biggest word you ever heard.
No, I'm really not supposed to speak to strangers, but we've met before.
I know you. I walked with you once upon a dream. I know you. The gleam in your eyes is so familiar a gleam. Yet I know it's true that visions are seldom all they seem. But if I know you, I know what you'll do.
But they love him, breaks a new heart every day. He's a tramp, they adore him, and I only hope he'll stay that way. He's a tramp, he's a scoundrel, he's a rounder, he's a cad. He's a tramp, but I love him. Yes, even I have got it pretty bad. You can never tell when he'll show up. He gives you plenty of trouble. I guess he's just a no-count pup. But I wish that he were double. He's a tramp. He's a rover. And there's nothing more to say. If he's a tramp, he's a good one. And I wish that I could travel his way. Wish that I could travel his way. Wish that I could travel his way.
Salagadoola, Menchikaboola, bibbidi bobbidi boo. Put them together, and what have you got? Bibbidi-bobbidi-boo. Salagadoola, menchikaboola, bibbidi-bobbidi-boo. It'll do magic, believe it or not. Bibbidi-bobbidi-boo.
Oh, salagadoola, menchikaboola, bibbidi-bobbidi-boo. Put them together, and what have you got?
A sweep is as lucky can be. Chim chiminy, chim chiminy, chim chim chiru. Good luck will rub off when I shake hands with you. Or blow me a kiss. And that's lucky too.
Now I'm the king of the swingers, oh, the jungle VIP. I've reached the top and had to stop, and that's what's bothering me. I wanna be a man cub, and stroll right into town. And be just like the other men. I'm tired of walking around. Oh, ooby-doo. I want to be like you.
Hop-dee-hooby-doo-bop.
I want to walk like you.
Chip.
Talk like you.
Chip-choo.
Weeby-dee-bee-doo. You see, it's true.
Shoo-bee-doo.
An ape like me.
Scooby-dooby-dooby.
Can learn to be human too.
Just whistle while you work. And cheerfully together we can tidy up the place. So I'm a merry tune. It won't take long when there's a song to help you set the pace.
For this is the night. It's a beautiful night. And we call it a band.
wish upon a star crystallized the Disney philosophy that all of our dreams could come true if we had the courage to pursue them.
If your heart is in your dream, no request is too extreme. When you wish upon a star, as dreamers do.
Just as Walt liked to use music to tell his stories, he used animals with individual personality to develop his characters. Began filming live animals where they lived, free, in nature's own wonder world. In the True Life Adventure series, nature and wildlife were the actors in dramas as old as life itself.
Come on.
television began to appear everywhere, Walt Disney felt that it could give him new ways to entertain. And in the early 50s, Disney did capture the airways with
Davy, Davy Crockett, king of the wild frontier.
10 million youngsters began sporting coonskin caps. Then came the Mickey Mouse Club.
The leader of the club that's made for you and me.
Hey there, hi there, ho there, you're as welcome as can be.
Forever let us hold our banner high.
Television programming, Walt turned to live-action motion pictures in a big way.
Well, we like a little mystery in our films, but there's really no secret about our approach. We keep moving forward, opening up new doors, doing new things, because we're curious. When you're curious, you find lots of interesting things to do. And one thing it takes to accomplish something is courage.
The shaggiest dog story of them all.
Pop?
Yes, Wilby?
I've got something to tell you. But I'm afraid.
Well, you never have to be afraid to talk to me, Wilby. Maybe sometimes I'm a little impatient with you, but that's because you're my son. So you just tell me what's troubling you. I'm sure it can't be anything too serious, but whatever it is, I promise you I'll understand.
Really, Pop?
You can bank on it, Wilby.
Shake on it?
Certainly I'll shake on it, Wilby.
A Volkswagen with a mind of its own arrived on the scene. A courageous Swiss family found high adventure in a tropical island wilderness.
Ready. Now! Rick, come up! Come up, Rick!
Absent-minded professor had everything flying high with Flubber.
Thank you.
then came Mary Poppins, who captivated the entire world.
After a long concentration on live action and cartoon films, we decided to try something that would employ about every trick we learned in the making of film. We would combine cartoon, live action, in an enormous fantasy, Mary Poppins. I never saw a sad face around the studio. This made me nervous. Suppose the staff had finally conceded that I knew what I was doing.
Walt also had a unique way of mixing comedy with pathos. He believed that with every laugh, there must be a tear someplace.
Could be Towden. I've been wanting that, too. All right, I'm opening it. What could it be?
Beaver, but we can't.
Cam, just sit. Don't you know happy crying when you hear it? You go right ahead, Lydia. Enjoy yourself.
Are you really happy, Ma?
Oh! Oh!
Come on, alley-oop. I gotta wash behind your ears. You ought to be proud. You're a success. Look, a peanut. Come on, eat it. Got lots of vitamins. Give you a lot of pep. Oh, I forgot to tell you. Why, we're going over to see your mother. I made an appointment for you. Didn't I tell you? Just like me, I must have forgot. Come on, get your hat. Right over there. Cozy little place, ain't it? Mrs. Jumbo. I hope she's in. Someone to see ya.
You had old Yeller.
lucky for us, son, but it weren't lucky for old Yeller.
He chewed up some, but he ain't bad hurt.
No wolf in his right mind would have jumped us at the fire. Not even a loafer wolf. That wolf was mad. Oh, shoot him, if you can't. But either way, we've got it to do.
Mama, listen. Old Yeller just saved your life, and Elizabeth, too. And he saved mine and Alice's. We can't. We don't know for certain. I'll pin him up where he can't get out, and then we'll wait. We can't just shoot him like he was nothing. Don't you understand?
All right, son. If you think there's a chance. No, Mama. There's no hope for him now, Travis. He's suffering. You know we've got to do it.
I know, Mama. He was my dog. I'll do it.
Was never satisfied. He was always reaching out for more exciting ways to bring pleasure to people.
Well, it took many years. It was a whole period of maybe 15 years developing. I started with many ideas, threw them away, started all over again. And eventually it evolved into what you see today as Disneyland. But it all started from a daddy with two daughters wondering where he could take them, where he could have a little fun with them too.
Almost everyone warned us that Disneyland would be a Hollywood spectacular, a spectacular failure. But we believed in our idea, a family park where parents and children could have fun together.
Well, our brothers had the worries of getting this money and fighting the bankers and things. And there was a time, I think it was after we opened the park, that our bankers said to my brother, they said, "We're not going to let you put another nickel in it." And my brother said, "Well, if you're going to start running our business, we're going out and find some other place we can borrow money." And by gosh, they finally gave him the money.
Even though he moved into other areas, Walt always considered motion pictures to be the heart of the company. Here, for example, are scenes from Robin Hood, the animated feature now in production.
You know, there's been a heap of legends and tall tales about Robin Hood. All different, too. Well, we folks of the animal kingdom have our own version. It's the story of what really happened in Sherwood Forest. Oh, incidentally, I'm Alan Adeo, a minstrel. Oh, that's an early day folk singer. And my job is to tell it like it is, or was, or whatever. Robin Hood and Little John walking through the forest, laughing back and forth at what the other has to say. Reminiscing this and that and having such a good time. Oodle-lolly, oodle-lolly, golly, what a day.
Oh. That sounds like another collection day for the poor, eh, Johnny boy?
Yeah, sweet charity.
Taxes! Beautiful, lovely taxes! Ah-ha! Ah-ha!
skill for encouraging contributions from the poor.
To coin a phrase, my dear counselor, rob the poor to feed the rich.
Am I right?
They may be bandits.
Oh, Bobbycock. Female bandits? What next? Rubbish. My dear ladies, you have my permission to kiss the royal hands. Hiss! Oh, you've hissed your last. Yes.
Crystal ball. I see your illustrious name.
I know my name. Get on with it.
Your name will go down, down, down in history, of course.
Yes, I knew it. I knew it. You hear that?
The jackpot.
Would happen. 7 years bad.
Ooh. Luck.
That's what it is. Besides, you broke your mother's mirror.
Oh, Mommy. I've got a dirty thumb.
Throughout his imaginative career, Walt had an uncanny ability to inspire creative talent. And now, and for the future, his creative team is dedicated to carrying on the Walt Disney philosophy. In October 1971, Walt Disney Productions opened Walt Disney World, perhaps Walt's greatest dream, one he was never able to see become a reality.
My greatest reward, I think, is that I've been able to build this wonderful organization and also to have the public appreciate and accept what I've done all these years. That is a great reward.